Monstrous! Oh, wonderful. Well, there's not as many. Wasn't there 8 last time? The party slowly advances. Let me hit this one. I guess I should have topped this off a little bit. Small healing for Edgel. And kill. Oh. Oh, is that queen? I didn't realize that. I thought it was just one behind the others. Oh, yeah, it's a different color. Let's thrash the queen. She's a killer. Bug Queen! Cannot penetrate the magical aura. Haven't seen that for a while. At least. Unless I missed it. Someone's sleeping. Selena's asleep. And is Valden as well? Wake up, Valden. I think we'll be taking a nap after this battle. Because that queen moves. Wait, which one's the queen? I guess this one. She's gonna attack Nelvin, that's no good. Like, I've had it up to here with you and your whirlwinds, buddy. Nice. Someone Edgel is fighting. Yeah, if they put him to sleep, Nelvin, oh, he's gonna be a sitting duck. I guess I'm always having Nelvin as a leader? I guess I had Selena as a leader. Yeah, I did choose her. When we were trying to have her go help us get through that door. Oh, Nelvin is asleep. That's no good. Oh boy. That's bad news. Well, wake him up. I don't want to move Valden down here because he's going to be in the Nelvin's way of getting out. In any case, hit that one. He can go with his throwing axe. She's waking him up. Oh, and Selena's asleep as well. She cast a lame spell on somebody. Poof. Who's lame? Is anybody lame? Oh, Nelvin is. Alright, well, we're gonna move him first. Out of oh! He can't move when he's lame. Aw. Oh. Really? He can't even defend. He can cast spells, though? blameless. She's casting on everybody, okay. The edge will start moving over. Sabine's asleep. We're attacking that. Attacking Nelvin. Oh, can't penetrate magical aura. Huh. Maybe we'll just leave him there after all. Poof! All we've got left is the queen. Alright. I say we keep him where he is then, if it's gonna keep deflecting. Let's, wake up Selena. Let's throw a fireball at the queen. Yeah. He's like the perfect foil for her right now. We're closing in on you, baby. Just in case, let's throw a small healing at him. I'm trying that mouse wheel. The mouse wheel has no function here, I'm afraid. And he's moving here. Okay. Nelvin deflected the lame spell, haha. Well, she deflected his spell as well. He's about out of mana. Got one more fireball in him? Yes, he does. Now Edgel joins the fight. Everyone join the fight right now. Maybe we'll get more off the queen. Maybe she'll give some decent experience. Boom. We can use a fire beam. Do that. She keeps trying to attack him to no avail. I love it. Alright, I don't think he has... one magical projectile. Not doing much damage. What are we, 12 or something? Nothing. Alright. You're incapable of attacking. Is he lamed again? He is, okay. Can't defend either, but he doesn't really need to. Alright, let's remove the lameness again. Oh, she cast it immediately again. On Nelvin again, I guess. So the magic, the throwing axe does not penetrate the magical aura. Yeah, He's lamed again. Lamed again. Now I want her a butt. Only two or three of us are gonna be able to attack before she moves again. Selena, Sabine. You know what? I might do some more damage if I actually put this on. Magical Assault. That might help their attacks so we could defeat her more quickly. Oh, attacking Edgel! Oh! Doing damage on him. Alright, we've got it up. While I'm at it, she's attacking again. Let's put the magical barrier up as well. And let's all start attacking her because she decided she's going to stay in the fight again. Sadly, Melvin's out of magic, and I don't want to waste a magic potion on someone who's almost dead. So that's that. Cheating again. She's using guerrilla tactics. I guess my barrier failed. Yeah, dude, that 14 and 21 damage now. That weapon buff really helps. Oops, what am I doing? You attack. I hit that instead of okay. Well, when they connect, it's good. I want to find out. How much she has left on her. Nine points. We just have to get her for 9 points. That's it. Eight. 1 point left, really. Did it. 96 experience. So how many were there? There was 5 of them, I think? So we got 3 each for 4 of them. Yes, I'm pretty sure the tower's working. So 12, so we got 84? 84 experience for the queen? That's not bad. I'll fight those queens. I will fight those queens. Alright. Before we take another step in here, I'm gonna save. I you never know when you're gonna hit some pit or something. Oh my god, what happened? That actually was a, like, I wouldn't call it a jump scare, but a jump startle? The pile of rags before you proves to be the horribly distorted skeleton of a dwarf. Amongst the remains, you see a scroll container. We'll take the pittance of gold and Dreblin's notes. Melvin will hold on to that. I wasn't expecting to see that. Well done graphic, I must say. Alright, Melvin has it. The scrolls show that these are the records of a forest runner by the name of Dreblin. It was an effort to find the ruins again. This is truly one of the most dangerous parts of the forest. As expected, at the entrance I was not able to get any further than the massive green gate. So now it is time to try out the climbing equipment. Done it! The equipment enabled me to climb the outside wall of the tower. I was able to look briefly at some of the strange wall drawings, but then a group of Gizeks forced me to withdraw through an opening in the ground. I succeeded in forcing myself through a second opening under a metal plate. I have now reached a deep part of the old system. I have not found anything valuable yet. Some doors block the way to other parts of the ruins. And here, too, many of the walls are decorated with strange symbols. I hear noises. Hopefully the Gizeks are not following me. They probably are. Hopefully he has some idea of what these symbols are. The symbols appear to be very important. They are also found next to the doors. The spheres on the doors can be depressed, but nothing happens. Apparently the symbols represent a system of numbers. Triangles could symbolize numbers. The round symbols are unknown. Perhaps they are multipliers? Are symbols next to each other simply to be added together? Probably. Red triangles could be the number one. Orange would then have to be... This is where the letters stop, as if a line had been drawn straight across the parchment. Well, he probably got killed at that point, or was fleeing for his life, and just ended up scribbling across the page. Or the... not scribbling, but the pen got drawn across the page, kind of thing, like... For trauma's sake, I would say he was unexpectedly, like, insta-killed. So, it doesn't say... I mean, who's to say if this guy's right or not? But it does say, at least here... that the red triangles are the number one. So I'm gonna proceed with that in mind. I still look like... say they look like flames. Orange... I'm gonna put a question mark. And so the round, which I did not notice, round, I thought... I saw them on the doors themselves. I'm gonna have to look again. The only round things I remember, I assume, were doorknobs for the gates. Round symbols. I'm gonna put multipliers with a question mark. Because we're not sure. Well, thank you for that, Dreblin. Hopefully find some other clue. Because it doesn't really give us much to go by. There's nothing else here, right? There's no symbols here on this wall. So I wonder what the purpose of this place is. Alright, so... is that the round symbol he's talking about? There? So, I mean, orange? These look yellow. So I don't know if that even pertains. Oh, that did that move? Oh no, it's just a... yeah, I forgot to turn the textures back on. I'm sorry, guys. 3D ceiling texture on. There we go. I mean, if it really is, if these are the orange ones, quote unquote, orange, and that's a multiplier, so that would be 2 times this, whatever that might be. It doesn't really give you much to go by. Maybe we'll find more clues elsewhere. I've not been this way, have I? It's another gate. We've got a... you know what? We need a rest. Most indubitably. Hop off and rest here. Does not require any rest. I could use one ration. He needs at least 2. And he's got rations. Okay. I guess we can't rest yet. Oh, we did. I want to get our cleric full up. And our mage. Alright, so we're good here. We've got 1. We're gonna have to waste Valden. One off of Valden. Have to wait for 8 hours so we can sleep for 8 hours. At least it's nighttime outside. It's always good to know. And we're good. I'm glad this place is lit up. Oh, we got more stuff. And let's save. Save. So these are the orange ones. These must be the orange ones. So it's 5. And then... oh no, the red triangles are 1. So So maybe this is one. Maybe is this supposed to be orange? So it looks yellow to me. Then again, we haven't found any more gates that are asking for numbers. Well, there's a round symbol, right? So we can't interact with this in any way. Oh, it probably controls this door. There's more of the symbols. Wow, okay. Well, let's go this way first. Striding through the ancient halls. That's interesting looking. You're gonna want a number, aren't you? Oh! These round symbols. Haven't seen them before. Okay. So I'm guessing this is red, this is orange. This definitely looks more of an orangey than the yellow we saw before. And this is a multiplier? Two multipliers? So maybe it's multiplying this flame because it's the same color. Or triangle, sorry. I still look like flames to me. I mean, I know it's pixelated, but can't they make more smoother triangles than that? They can. I know they can. So red is one? One? Times one is one. We're multiplying one, I'm guessing. Because it's that color. Does the color correspond? So if you're just multiplying one, it's just one. So then maybe this is either the orange, he wasn't sure. He got cut off before he could say it or write it. So this is one and then two? Or maybe it's supposed to be 10. So either, or maybe it's this together multiplied twice. That would mean that these colors don't correspond to specifically that one triangle. So it's 12 multiplying what? Itself? The door ignores all your attempts to open it and remains closed. Maybe it's... So maybe this is 11. Times what? Oh! Sometime after one of the spheres was last pressed against the door, two metal plates screech slowly to one side. The door is open.